Do you feel underdressed at the Ren Fair? Maybe your kilt just isn't cutting it anymore. Or does your child want to be a fighter, but you can't afford the gear? Or is it just that the maidens won't give you the time of day? What you need is Jack of all ages, chainmail for beginners. We'll show you how to dress like a man at arms with the pay of a peasant. Welcome to Jack of All Ages. Enjoy the show.
Hello, YouTube, and welcome to Jack of All Ages. Today, I'm going to take a step back in time. Time of chivalry. A time of wonder. A time of fantasy. Well, a lot of people fantasize about this time period. It has inspired games of all different kinds, role-playing games, the most famous being Dungeons and Dragons. It hasn't stopped there. What I'm going to talk about today is chainmail. This is an imitation of the kind of armor that they wore back during the medieval age. And before any of you purists out there say anything negative, no, this is not how they would have made it, and this is not how you can get it today. But for the amateur, this is the easiest and the cheapest way to do it. Now, a lot of you out there might think that it's difficult to make chainmail. Not really. If anything, it can be boring and time-consuming. But chainmail has been known to stop knives. It was very useful against stopping swords. What chainmail protected you from was cutting damage. You could hit something with chainmail on... do something really quick in order to make it so that my phone does not make any sound. I'm going to turn the sound on. Alright. So, chainmail. Let us start, shall we? I'm making chainmail. You need to make the links. And when I said it's the cheapest form, a very protective armor out there, I mean the cheapest form. This is made up of a common household item. In fact, it's made up of over 52 of them. There is over 1,000 links here. And 52 of these items made 1,000 links. Actually, 1,040. A little bit more, give or take. You might ask what it is. Funny you should ask. The easiest way to make chainmail with coat hangers. Now, in the old days, the blacksmith or the armor might draw out, you know, a long line, or might even draw out small, like, nail-shaped items with a little eyelet on one side that he would loop, he would feed through the eye, and then he would weld shut with each link. We're not going to do that. As you can see, with this, the links are just butted closed. But it's still quite strong. So, in order to make this into that, you need a couple pieces of tool. First, you need something to cut the coat hanger. Because this twist here is going to cause you some problems. So first what you do is you, right here below the twist, take these little miniature bolt cutters. I'm not entirely sure what they're for. I found them at Sears Hardware Store. And you'll cut it off just below the twist. Gives you the most usable material for your chainmail. Then, take yourself a pair of pliers, grab near each bend, and straighten it out as best you can. You don't have to be perfect. You just have to get it as straight as you can. Oh, and it's interesting to note, not just any coat hangers will make chainmail. Well, any of them will. Some of them more difficult to work than others. But it's important that when you make chainmail, you get coat hangers all of the same gauge. Otherwise, you'll get, you know, these thick ones, or you'll get thin ones, and yeah, it won't look good. So I find that the cheap dry clean coat hangers work the best. You could spend money. You could go and purchase, you know, a whole big spool of wire. It'd be a whole lot less time consuming. But then it wouldn't be cheap. All right. So, as you can see, I've left this one little bend. You'll see what that's for later. Something else I want to show you. You see how this patch of chainmail here looks nothing like this beautiful bronze-looking wire here, right? It looks like nice, shiny steel chainmail, little patches of rust here and there. Here's why. This gold color, this bronze color, whatever, on the outside of this coat hanger is plastic coating. It's to protect the coat hanger wire to keep it from rusting. It's going to come off in the whole batch. Now, you can do this the easy way, which I'm going to show you. Or you could do this the hard way, which I'm going to explain to you. When I first started making chainmail, I would take a rod, a piece of bar stock. I use this brass because it's easy to bend. And the first time I did it, it was just a straight piece of bar stock. What you do is you would take your piece of coat hanger, and you would take a pair of vice grips and you would clamp it down there, and then you would just wrap it by force. We're not going to do that. In another video, I will show how I made this chainmail making jig, or link making jig. But you can find them out there on the internet. By the way, it's really hot here. Well, hot for me. So here's the chainmail jig. Doesn't need to be this big. What you need are two bolts with wing nuts, two large washers, and two pieces of leather. You can use 2x4s, but I find 2x6 is better. You need a section of 2x6. You need to drill a hole for the bolts to go through, and a hole for your piece of bar stock that you've bent into this handle shape. Now, one of the things I did with this bar stock is I drilled a hole in that bar stock that will fit my chainmail wire. It's important. So, now that you have this set up, I'm only going to show you one coiling of the links, because I have a coil in here and many cut links already for the purpose of saving time. Slide your bar into your jig base. We want to bring it down here. Then you're going to slide this through these two pieces of leather. The leather is to provide friction. You want to have some resistance when you are twisting this. That way it pulls it to the rod. Now I'm going to have to move the camera so that you can see this. Actually, maybe I'll move myself and the camera so that you can see this better. I'm going to set it here. And I'm going to sit here. We're going to bring this down a little bit. All right. So, here we have chainmail jig. So I pull this through. Now, because I like to do my links all in one direction, I'm going to spin this way. Pull this back. Oops. Yeah, I forgot. All right, so I'm going to loosen this up a little bit so that I can get this in. It's been a while since I've done my chainmail making. All right, let's do this the other way. It doesn't matter which way your links go, really. So you feed your coat hanger through the wire. Tighten this back down. You want good tension. Tension is important. And then all it is a matter of turning this and pulling out as you turn. The reason you pull out is you want to feed that wire. Let's see if you can get a good view of this. I'm going to feed that wire on the inside of this coil. Alright. Here is where you've got to be a little bit careful. We're going to come here to the end. You see that popped out there like that? All right. Now, in order to get the most out of this, take my channel locks. And bringing this out. Actually, I don't even need my channel lock so much as my own thumb. I should follow the rule of one of my favorite YouTubers. I find this guy absolutely hilarious. Crazy Russian Hacker. All right, so there you go. Now, pull that back out. It's down. It's move things back around. Separate it from this to make that, and then we need to cut it into lengths. Like so. Oh, I just realized the bad side of this little table of mine here. Got holes in the bottom, but in any case, so take your cutters, reach down here on this first link, and pink, comes right off. Now, I had at one time had a plan of setting up a jig with a Dremel and a metal cutting disc and just place this whole thing in the jig and then just zip it right through. I'll take it, cut all these down. I haven't done that yet, but it's okay. So now I can't take this little bit here. So I'm going to come down to where it's right there, and you get it right up there next to the next link. Squeeze. And you drop that little link. You go right up. Actually, I'm not even going to go to that spot yet. I'm going to come back here. Now I remembered why I like to twist the other direction. Next time I'll make sure to put it in the rod before I slide it through the tensioners. I like to work with this on this side of the thing, but I can work with both. So you cut it, length. Lean it up against, cut it. Okay, let's get on with the next part. So now what you need to do, as the name describes, is create a chain. So what you do is you take your first link, grab it like so, okay? Take your second link and twist it away. But I just remembered. Your first link needs to be closed, so when you twist it back, okay, remember, twist it back and push it together, and link number one. Here's something that you run into every now and then. This link is a little malformed. You can fix that problem by pinching it like so. It's a little bit carefully. If it doesn't pinch very well, then don't worry about it. It's close. So you can see that I've twisted this the opposite direction of what I did today. This is an old link. So again, pinch it, spread it, link it, close it. This one's not going to be so good. I'm going to throw that link out. Don't be afraid to throw away links. It's coat hangers after all. They're incredibly cheap. Grab it. Usually, I don't use these big channel locks. I use small ones. And don't grab it wimpy. You got to put a good grip on this. And it's just like that. So I'm going to sit here and I'm going to make a chain. And we're going to go with a chain of, we'll see, maybe 20 links. Maybe 30. No, it depends. I might have to cut this next link, set of links. So now, for actually knitting these together, this is where the hard part comes in. You're going to put one link through two. I'm going to show you how that works. Okay, so here we are. The next step. So with the next step, same as before, take your link, spread it. Now, like I said earlier in this, you're going to be putting this one link through two, these two. I will show you why once I have put this together. Okay, so now as you can see, those two are facing the same way. And you're going to do that all the way down the row. Don't worry about the other ones. You'll see how that comes in next. Okay, now we've gotten to an end where where I don't have a link that I can link to. It's really simple. You can't link through two links to match this. Just link through one. Just like that. All right, so now, stage one. Now, the way that you do this, actually we're gonna flip this over. The way that you're gonna do this is you're gonna link one link here through these two. Like so. Open. And then the way I do this is I just link down, through, up. Just like that. They got these fancy jigs for making this thing easier. And one of these days, I really should make one. Because it will make this whole process so much easier. Now, you can't really see the difference now. Or maybe you can. Maybe you've got that good of an eye. But, and this is the other reason why I like to do it the other way, is because I'm right-handed. I like to have the loop this way. One, two, this part will get a whole lot easier the bigger it gets. You won't have to worry about which way your links are facing. They'll all want to face the same way because they'll have tons of buddies there saying, this is the way to go. Here's where I'm messing things up. See, I almost started a new set on the wrong side of the tracks there. That would have totally messed things up. So, quick note, pay attention to how your links are going. Otherwise, you're going to end up in trouble. Because later on, we get into harder linkings, which I hate to do. All right, folks. So that was the next part. As you can see, each of the links we're going to be working with next lay down on the table. So you want to take this and you want to flip it. And what this does is it gives you a whole line of links in which to work with. And the links that we're working with are these links here. And then these links here. What you end up with is a 1 through 4 pattern. There's one link here through these four links. Now there are a whole lot of other very difficult chainmail combinations you can do, but if you want to start basic and simple, this is the way to go. So I'm going to do a few more rows. I really don't want to do too much in this because the problem that you then have once you've built chainmail is you've got to knit it together. Now, it's easy to put one link through two links, but when you have to knit it together, you have to knit one link through four links, which means you have a whole lot less space to work with. So, like I said, I'm going to do a little bit more. This is from a previous, and what I may just end up doing is knitting this into that. So, let's check something out here, shall we? So now, this here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. This is 30 rows. This bad boy here is 1, 2. What? Oh, I already start doing some. No, another one. One, two. I did. I put two links in here already. So this has already got two links in, which is kind of messed up, but all right, so we're going to do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. That's 40. 40. So this is 30. I need to do another 5 more to match it up to that. And then comes the fun part of knitting them all together. As you can see, it's getting easier to do each set of links the more you get, that they want to lay a certain way. Now, I thought that I was almost done. Actually, I thought that with this one I would be done. But I realized my mistake. I was counting wrong. I made it through elementary school. I should know how to count. But, so, 17, 18, 19, 20. You would think I was done, right? Wrong. This row has to come on. So, I got two more. No big deal. Keep dropping down those cracks. So, next is going to come the really hard part. Because in order to attach this to that, I then have to knit 1 through 4. I can do that. It's just really tedious and long and hard. All the good garbage. Oop. I gotta twist this in. You can't leave too big a gap or the links fall apart. Alright, so we have that. Let's knit together some chain. So, because I have these two links here first, I need to link that through that. So, I'm going to take this, and I'm going to go like this, and we're going to see where that puts me. Right? This should be like, let's bring this closer so that flat surface. Probably the worst surface to do this with. Is that right? No, that's not right. Alright, let's do this the easier way. Undo this. By the way, I don't know if any of you know this about metal, but when you bend it back and forth like this, you actually are tension treating it. You make it harder, actually. This is where the hard part comes in. So, this has got a link through that. And through that. Okay, the hard part. Because you actually lose a lot of room to grab the chainmail when you do this. So it takes a lot more force. The wrists. So. Ah, come on. So difficult. There we go. Okay, let's see if that worked. All right, that worked. See? Now you understand why it's so difficult to knit together two things of chain yarn. And let's see if this will do the trick. And there you have it. So, in order to get this right, I'm going to have to knit an entire row of now 38 links into this to knit these two pieces together. Let's see if I've got. So the only reason why I'm not quitting now and saying, there you have it, you can knit these together and this is how, is because that'd be quitting. So what's going to happen here is a lot of what you've seen is going to be fast forwarded and we're going to get to the end. But you're going to see it all be done. It's going to all knit together. As you can see, I've knitted this whole section together. If it weren't for the slats in this, which I'm going to go away from the next time, you would see good product. It's not the best linking job, because normally I would work this way. But it is working. So, that said, let's get on with it. Alright folks, here we are. I never thought we would make it the last link on knitting this together. Let's check it, then we'll take a look at it and see how poorly I did. At no point in time do I want you to think that I think that I am an armorer. That's not what this show is all about. This is Jack of All Ages, taken from the phrase Jack of All Trades. At no point in time do I ever claim to be an expert in this or many of the other hobbies or crafts that I do, but I do have some knowledge and skill in them. And my goal is to pass that along to you. You got more out of this video than I had originally intended. So, let's check, shall we? No gaps. Everything is linked nicely together. And there we have it. Your introduction to chainmail. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, click like down below. And then ring the bell if you want to get more get notifications of any of my upcoming videos or my videos that are posted out. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe here. And then over here on the left, I have two videos for you to watch. Now with that said, I hope you enjoyed the video and keep coming back to see more. Oh yeah, leave comments whether you liked it or not. And if you didn't like it, click on the thumbs down button.